Redesigning offices and common work areas in the pandemic and beyond is the topic of my discussion today with Brad Simmons. He is managing partner with KAI. Brad, welcome.
Thank you. Glad to be here, Bob.
So with so many working remotely these days, Brad, I even have to wonder if we still need traditional office space going forward. What do you think about that?
You know, I think that's a question a lot of owners, a lot of our clients, a lot of real estate developers are all asking the same global question right now: is this a pivot point in how we look at home office real estate, how we look at our own facilities, and is there a way to still have that home office feel and the things you need for that, because some of it becomes cultural and connect, you know, and the connectional aspects of it to actually get our job done, you know, versus what you can do remotely. Now, I think we've all shifted that fairly universally now.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you certainly have raised the question. I guess nobody knows the answer. Clearly, we're going to need some kind of office space going forward. But how different do you think it might look in the future?
I suspect, while coronavirus and the current pandemic are the, you know, the rage right now, let's not kid ourselves. In a globally connected world, and with the kind of things we're seeing, the kind of tumult we're seeing on a global basis, I can't imagine this is going to be the last. I think we've probably taken a new step forward in some of the challenges we'll all be facing. But I do think. I think folks that either, you know, own office properties, real estate properties, or those that us that help us, you know, direct and steer clients on those, or those that at least those are going to have to really rethink. And yeah. I think it starts with looking at your own workforce really honestly and openly, and you know, really trying to understand strategically what do you need to do to operate your business. My sense is a lot of people talked. Virtual, they talked global, and I don't know a lot of companies really until this pandemic forced a serious use of that technology, really embraced it. I think there was a lot of talk and maybe not as much actual reality to it. But I think this has forced a hard discussion internally at businesses at the highest levels of companies at their board level. How are we going to operate?
One thing I would assume, could be wrong about this, but I would think that if some degree of remote work continues, and I think we can agree that it's certainly a possibility for some companies, for at least some of their staff, they're going to need less space, less floor space. Office space could potentially at least be smaller, right?
Yeah, I think that's the initial reaction, but I'm not sure, you know, Bob, that's actually the answer, because if you think about it, let's think about when someone comes to visit you at your office, whether, you know, let's say you have an outside visitor, a customer, a vendor, a collaborator, somebody comes in. I think we have to think about every single thing that happens when you enter the door to that office. So it ranges from everything. How do we enter the building? You know, we're used to touching handles on doors. Did everything go to electronic doors, automatic doors? How do we even sit in a reception space with social distancing? With how is the receptionist greet you? How do things happen in terms of offering you a cup of coffee or a tea or a Coke or whatever it might be, a soft drink? How does that happen when you go into an office room? Go into a conference room. So right now our conference rooms, I think in most places, you know, we pack people in every 3 feet apart. We've got them in a chair. What if the conference rooms remain the same size, but you've got to start spacing people differently? So my premise, Bob, is that we actually may need the same amount of square footage, but we may use it differently in conference rooms with larger spacing gaps in between, with kitchens and employee break room areas that facilitate a broader distance and an ability to socially distance in there. You know, there's been a trend for many years about private offices. Well, a lot of companies, let's go to an open office structure. Right. I think we found that many companies swung the pendulum so far one way, it probably didn't work as well in the fully open. So there's, I think you're looking at things, maybe there's more need for private offices. So I would actually, you know, postulate that there could be a swing actually the opposite way with either the same space or more but potentially using it in a very different way with more mm-hmm. private or more secure opportunities as these things happen.
Yeah, certainly the open plan has been the way that so many businesses have gone in recent years. And of course, it's almost a cliche, the cubicle environment in many offices. Would you think we are going to see less of that, the cubicle aspect?
I actually think we're still going to see cubicles. I think what we're going to see are not the seas, I call it the ocean or the sea of cubicles. It looks like a giant, you know, egg crate or something. Mm-hmm. I think we're going to see more. I think we'll see more individualized workspace, potentially spaced out in different ways with much more flexibility in how people can work, in smaller groups, distance more appropriately. So I don't think you'll see the large seas of the sea of cubicles we have seen. I think you'll gradually see moving. The initial idea will be to, probably space people differently, but I think ultimately the entire space planning, interior design approach is going to begin to shift where we look at new concepts on how to space people.
Yeah, but think about human reaction to the moment. Right now, of course, we see this all making a lot of sense. And what if we go and we redesign all these offices with all this space and people aren't near each other anymore? And then the pandemic is over and people are like looking at each other in an office environment saying, why are we doing this? Why are we sitting 6 feet apart? There's no disease going on right now. Don't you think that they would tend to like pivot back toward their old ways, even in a redesigned or reconfigured office environment?
Perhaps. I do think this pandemic has really shaken people up a bit on in thinking about how we, our proximities, our distancing, our personal interactions with people, you know, ranging from shaking hands to now we fist bump or hit an elbow or something like that. You know, I think it's changed that. Now, with that said, we're only a few years or maybe a generation away from people forgetting this ever happened. But again, I think we now know that these types of incidents are probably going to become more prevalent as we have such a globally connected world mm-hmm. that easily disease, easily, different types of challenges can cross-pollinate very quickly, faster than we all think.
There's a lot of thought being given to the idea that going forward long-term that there'll be a lot less business travel. And maybe a lot of companies are looking forward to that because of the cost of that. And so why not? That being the case, maybe we'll just get more used to the fact of having meetings such as this with our clients and our contacts in other offices. And that would translate into a feeling like we don't even need to be face-to-face in an office anymore. Again, this idea that remote work becomes more part of our everyday life. Do you think, do you see a train of thought that leads back to the idea that we don't need to be in offices together at all?
Well, I hope not. I think fundamentally we all desire, we all need, and we have something emotionally that drives that desire for human connection. And I know in our business world of design and construction, specifically design, that human interaction, that ability to really all get around the table and debate an idea. Yes, you can do it. But you know, the personal sort of sketching and looking at an idea, there's an emotional attachment to that I think is going to be hard to give up. And I think, you know, we don't want to give it up. That's one of the things I worry about, Bob, is that we will get too comfortable with this and it's going to damage our ability to connect, really connect as thinkers, connect mm-hmm. as people that really want to collaborate together. The days, and as someone who spent for a number of years, probably every other week on a global flight, I don't have a problem with less global travel, mm-hmm. but I also think there is something about face-to-face meetings that is just, I don't know how to put my finger on it, but it gives you a different connection. I think we're going to have to work really hard to have those same connections, through a virtual meeting environment. And I just don't know we can overcome need to have that personal connectivity at some point.
When we do set forth to redesign offices, change the furniture, change the spacing, change the walls, do you think we need to do it hand in hand with technology? How important is the role of technology, for instance, in testing people, making sure that they're healthy, and any other aspect of it that might help us adjust to this future environment?
I think it's huge. I think technology, again, I think a lot of people have promoted their firms or businesses are, you know, really up there with technology and really making it happen. And I don't think that reality was really there. So now let's imagine a world that, again, we were talking about walking into an office building. What if there's a technology? And I got to believe it's out there. So I see not only technology, but I see medicine and I see design. I see architectural engineering, all this coming together in a tighter way. So imagine an office where you walk in and because of technology scanning devices, maybe your body is scanned, your temperature is taken, you're automatically checked for, as a pre-screen or something for the last time you had a COVID test or whatever the next thing might be. So do you have a temperature? Do you have any kind of, any type of illness right now? So I think technology will play a role in that as we begin to work with the medical field and our architects and engineers to look for ways to, in a sort of non-invasive way, quickly look at somebody coming in the doors, employees and visitors. So I'm not sure this is not going to drive more of a convergence of science, medicine, and the building design and construction industry.
All with the purpose, I guess, of maybe making sure that we stay in physical spaces together and that we don't all, you know, retreat to our individual office, you know, individual homes and not have contact anymore. But those are some great points you make, Brad Simmons of KAI, about how we might look freshly at the redesign of offices in the future to ensure the continuing of human contact. Thank you so much for this virtual meeting, at least, to talk about non-virtual getting together. Thanks a lot for your help. Really appreciate you being with me.
Bob, a pleasure to be there and a great subject, and then look forward to talking again. Thank you.
Thank you.